Did you know that building codes require smoke shelf access for cleaning? IRC code R1003.17 states, "Cleanout openings shall be provided within 6 inches of the base of each flue within every masonry chimney. The upper edge of the cleanout shall be located not less than 6 inches below the lowest chimney inlet opening. The height of the opening shall not be less than 6 inches. The cleanout shall be provided with a non-combustible cover. Exception: chimney flues serving masonry fireplaces where cleaning is possible through the fireplace opening." NFPA 211 states, 11.2.6, accessibility. "For cleaning purposes, means shall be provided for access to the venting area above and immediately behind any movable damper valve plate in masonry fireplaces and steel fireplace units by one of the following methods. 1. A damper plate that can be removed with common hand tools. 2. A cleanout opening located to provide access to the smoke chamber area. Cleaning the smoke shelf is very important. If you have ever spent an hour trying to remove a rusted cotter pin that has fused to a damper plate, then you will realize that not removing a damper plate is a common practice by many chimney sweeps in the industry. There have been many times that we have cut a cotter pin with a Dremel rotary hand grinder to allow for damper plate removal. This type of removal is not a common hand tool. Unfortunately, this places chimney sweeps in a difficult situation. If they can't remove the damper very easily, many will try to lift the damper plate off the damper housing with the arm attached and do a poor job of cleaning a smoke shelf. It is even more difficult to remove damper plates that have rotary-style dampers or double ratchet dampers. There are many in the industry who will say how difficult it is to simply remove a cotter pin. Those are the same people who remove damper plates that have easily removable cotter pins and will do a poor job of cleaning the smoke shelf in the more difficult to remove plates by curling a vacuum hose over a damper plate or other poor quality techniques. So, what is the answer? We charge additional to remove a damper plate for cleaning. The time required to remove and replace a damper is nearly the same amount of time required to connect chimney rods together and sweep a chimney. It is not fair to overcharge clients who have dampers that are already removed and can be cleaned very easy. On every job with masonry dampers, we cut the cotter pin with a Dremel and replace with new cotter pins that can be easily removed during the next cleaning. We also recommend energy-efficient cap dampers to all our clients, so they do not need to pay additional for the damper plate removal and replacement during future cleanings. The cap damper allows for a more unobstructed draft and reduces creosote buildup. Finally, you may encounter steel form fireplaces, heat-elators, and chimneys that do not have access from the fireplace to clean the smoke shelf. This is a serious problem, and it needs to be addressed to the homeowners. They need to have a rear access cleanout door cut into their masonry chimney to allow for cleaning. They're going to say things to you like, "I've had this chimney cleaned for 1,000,000 years and no one has ever told me I have to have it done this way. You're trying to rip me off." This is when you show them the building codes and walk away. If you clean this chimney and all the creosote piles on the smoke shelf, then one day that creosote is going to catch on fire. The amount of fuel can catch surrounding timber members on fire, and the entire house can burn down. Hopefully no one is injured, but the first thing their homeowner insurance is going to say is who cleaned your chimney. Then they will sue you and your insurance company. By not properly cleaning a chimney, your insurance company will lose the claim and pay the damages. Then your insurance company drops you because they don't like to insure stupid people. When you try to get new insurance, they look at your past claims and either charge you a fortune or they turn you down. Every time you cut a corner or misdocument defects, it places you at risk. Educate your customers regarding building codes, and if they want to use your service, then great. But if they want to call someone else, then don't stress over it. The risk your competitors are taking is too much for your clients and your business.